Shannon. And I'm Laura.
And this is our presentation on organisation responsibilities, and we've chosen to talk about the brand.
Okay, so employer legislation. So what the company's expected to do. So the first one's breaks. And for every 20 minute that you work throughout the day, for every 6 hours you work throughout the day, you're entitled to a 20 minute break. And then as a daily thing, you're supposed to have 11 hours in between your hours of work. So if you finished work at 8, then you shouldn't start till 7 the next morning. Obviously, you'd like them to pay them, so you take all the details when you first got them, all the bank details, everything, so they can be paid on time. You'd have an accountant to do your finances so they were correct, and you'd have time sheets like this one so they could check in and out at the end of every day. Also, equal opportunities. So River Island try and employ a diverse range of people, so they attract different types of people for different types of jobs and offer different packages. For example, they offer like after school shifts and temporary contracts to attract students.
Okay, so customer legislation, what they're expected. They expect it to be clean, so they employ staff to clean the stores and to ensure that the stores are kept looking presentable and organised at all times. The employees have good personal hygiene because they'll be handling the clothes, and to ensure the products are kept to the hygiene standards. The other one is that the products are not damaged, so they offer discounts on clothes that are slightly damaged. They recycle the badly damaged clothes, and the stores have rules saying you can't eat or drink in them, which helps keep the clothes undamaged and clean. And they're careful with the products with packaging and unpackaging. They also make sure that the people that have manufactured them have been treated fairly by ensuring employee legislations are met, and they check the work conditions of the factories are kept to and ensure that they discuss ways to improve this. And the last one is for affordable price. They use low-cost fabric, have sales to encourage people to come in and buy last season's clothing, and they offer staff discounts, what encourages the staff to shop there and for people to work.
Okay, so health and safety. So what the companies are expected to do is basically they're expected to follow health and safety acts, make sure that things are stored, handled and used and transported safely. They offer training, instruction and supervision to basically ensure that staff are always trained to do things properly, provide a safe place for employment, a safe working environment, and have policies and risk assessments in place in case they don't. So they signed the Bangladesh Factory Safety Accord, which is apparently a good thing. And this is just another case study of something that happened where a trapdoor fell on someone's head and they were prosecuted, and it says that they cooperated fully with the council during this investigation and had taken steps to avoid a repeat incident, which means that they provided a safer workplace.
At the bank, what the company is expected to do, they're expected to have a credit limit, which means that River Island manages its cash flow by having people take the money from the store and take it to the bank, which means they're less likely to be overdrawn and owe the bank money. And they try to deposit it quickly and have a routine of when to deposit it. And a financial statement is taken by an editor, which gives the bank trust, as it means they can see what clothing's in there and how much it will go for, so they know they can give them a loan and they pay it back.
So global warming. So what they expect is to reduce, reuse and recycle, buy energy efficient products and encourage others to conserve. Okay, and what the company do is they try to reduce problems the environment is having, reduce the level of product packaging and increasing the levels of recycling and increasing the use of biodegradable materials.
Suppliers. It says on the River Island website they operate as a global chain network, sourcing and manufacturing their products throughout the world, which means they're funding all different suppliers from different places. They keep the partnerships together. It says on their website, our supply chain partners are important to us and build strong, long-term, ethically responsible manufacturing relationships are the key to success, which means they're keeping to their. And they make sure the payments don't get behind, as they're still doing business together, and they're still in partnership together.
Thank you for listening.